Welcome to Sports Strategies. My guest is Bob Hunter of Maple Leaf Sports and Entertainment, and we're discussing the expansion of Toronto's BMO Field. Bob, we spoke about the potential for the expanded facility to host more soccer matches and other sporting events, but the question of ground sharing with the Toronto Argonauts is now a reality after the purchase of the club by MLSC. How's the expansion project being amended in order to accommodate the Toronto Argos as a second tenant?
Key piece is really the rebuilding of the north and the south end zone. As you can appreciate, the CFL football field is a lot longer than a TFC or Major League Soccer field. So, you know, we're adding basically 20, 30 yards in each end zone. Demolition, especially in the north, is quite significant. So there were two group sales buildings there. There was a grandstand there that held almost 2,000 people. That completely disappears. South end zone, we've got six rows that we're going to have to convert to portable seats now. So exactly the same experience that you have today as to the distance to the pitch, but the reality is those seats have to come out for CFL football. In each end zone, there will be actually artificial turf used versus natural grass because the amount of time it's covered wouldn't allow us to use grass. So we've worked with the league to get their approval to convert the end zones to, with a proper transition, obviously player safety being critical, so that it will be artificial turf in the two ends. So that part of it. And then, you know, you don't want to lose the atmosphere that you create for TFC in either end zone. So the south goes back to what it is with temporary. In the north, we're creating what we're calling a patio experience so that we'll put six rows of seats in, but behind that will be a fairly significant party zone.
Bob, can you explain how the reinforced turf upgrade that's scheduled for phase two will allow the facility to host both soccer and CFL football during the same season?
Well, that is actually an option that we have going forward. We've decided that in our initial year, till we actually understand, how would I say, I don't want to say the damage, but the wear and tear that right. The CFL football will have on the turf, we've held off actually going ahead with that. If at the end of the season we conclude that that's a must, then it's really a matter of a 2 to 3 week stitching program where you actually bring in these large units from Europe and they stitch in plastic fiber into the turf, into the grass. Mm. So it's still natural grass, but what this does is provide additional root support and strength to accommodate more use. Mm-hmm. And so that option is there. We've met with the suppliers. We know exactly the amount of time and the cost that's required. But what we've done for this year is we've actually bought two different real fields that are growing up in mid Ontario. And if we find that the turf is suffering more wear and tear than anticipated, we'll actually just remove it and replace it during the season, which the whole field. And we need about a week to do that, and we've got blocks in the schedule that we think we can. The differential this year is that TFC won't start till early May again, so and that Argos don't start till July 1st. So we're kind of guessing what we're going to do this year, but we've got alternative and backups in case we find that the football is too difficult or too tearing on the pitch and is not allowing us to provide a good surface for TFC.
Now, Bob, you mentioned that the 2016 Grey Cup will be another major sporting event to be hosted by BMO Field. There's a distinct possibility that the playoff runs of both the Argos and TFC would overlap, and TFC conceivably could host one or more MLS playoff games at the same time. How much time will be needed to transition the stadium from soccer to CFL football and back? And what steps will be taken to accommodate both events in the likelihood they'll both be played here in Toronto?
Well, it's really a scheduling exercise. And the way that both leagues' playoff scenarios work, they only play their games on the weekends. And for us, it's really a matter of they can play 2 days in a row, both teams, but soccer just has to go first.
Sure.
Football is obviously the more stressful on the pitch, and it's really just a matter of us working with the leagues to ensure that if TFC has a weekend game that they play Saturday, and we'll be fine for Argos on Sunday. The field, from what we understand and the research that we've done, probably takes about 5 days to recover. So we need 5 days break between football and TFC again. And that's the way the schedule's being laid out now for the during the season. So we get into playoffs. Again, the scenarios are totally always unknown. You don't know whether you're the away team, the home team. You don't know whether you're playing Saturday or Sunday. You don't really know until the last day of the season for both clubs. And then it's just a matter of how you organize the scheduling.
Bob, what are some other future potential hosting opportunities that MLSE is considering for BMO Field? Are concerts and music festivals a possibility?
I would say on the sporting side, absolutely. It's an open slate. You know, we've had a great relationship with the Rugby Canada for the last couple of years and have hosted either one or two games each year. And there's a sport that takes its toll on the turf, obviously. So it's more of a programming challenge based upon when they've got European or international teams that they want to play. But no, I mean, if from any international soccer to any international football to any international rugby, I mean, that's what the stadium is there for. It's just really, again, a matter of programming to ensure that everybody gets an excellent pitch when they play. So we're hoping to expand that. The concert business is a challenging one in that, it really takes its toll on the field because you've got to cover it for 4 or 5 days. Weight is a big issue, obviously, because we have an underground heating and cooling system, underground drainage and aeration system that is installed at great expense. We really are cautious about any potential damage to that. So, you know, the amphitheater sits 200 yards south of it. You know, we've been partners with Live Nation on all the concerts that they produce and all the shows that they do here. So between us, Rogers Center, and the amphitheater, we're not sure that BMO needs to have a lot of concerts because of the other options that are available to it. We'd love to do the business because people want to be outdoor in the summertime, but we got a beautiful amphitheater there, and I think they'll end up hosting most of it.
Bob Hunter, thank you very much for joining us on Sports Strategies. We hope to chat again very soon to discuss the progress and eventually the completion of the facility.
You're welcome. It's great to be on the show.
Once renovation is completed in the spring of 2016, BMO Field will be transformed from a soccer-specific venue to a state-of-the-art, multi-purpose facility capable of hosting several different sporting events in a number of unique configurations. It represents the evolution of the 21st century sporting arena, where athletic endeavors, design, and technology coincide to provide the ultimate fan experience. You can have your say on the subjects that were discussed today on Sports Strategies. You can express your point of view to the program via social media using any one of these access links.
The exciting things that the organizing committee for the Toronto 2015 Pan Am Games put into place, one of the mandates was that any facility was going to come with sort of a skin in the game from a community that was going to host that facility. So the funding model is effectively and very generally, we'll bring you 66 cents on the dollar, you come up with the other 33 cents, and you've got yourself a world-class sport facility of some sort.